actually have, as I say, four behavioural styles, and ours are actually given character names. And our first character, behavioural preference, is what we call the ever ready. So this is very much an action orientated behavioural style. They like to be occupied with work that has a sense of achievement, quite focused, determined people, and they value other people based on their competency. Can't say the word, competency, an ability to actually achieve. People that have a high preference in the ever ready area come across as quite blunt, direct speaking individuals and can be seen by others as quite impatient. So for the purposes of the session today, I'm going to use the example, the stressor, of having a high workload, because that's a situation or a stress that many people can actually relate to. So someone with an ever-ready behavioural preference, you may think, well, if they thrive on challenge and being stretched, and they actually live life in a fast lane, they like a fast pace, they like to get things done, then probably they won't actually find having a high workload stressful at all. However, by having that deeper understanding and awareness of the preference, then we can start to understand why an ever-ready may still show signs of stress and experience those feelings of stress when they do have a high workload. So, the real cause of stress then is not the actual volume of work. It occurs when the individual cannot see how the work is aligned to their goals or targets and things which are important to them. So when this isn't clear, they think that their time is being wasted. And one of the real sources of stress for an ever ready is wastage. Wastage of time, wastage of resources. So if they cannot clearly see how the work is aligned to their targets or goals, if they cannot clearly see what's in it for me, then their thinking will be around what a waste of time this is. And that is where the real source of stress starts to occur. Because if they had a similar volume of work, which was clearly aligned to their goals, they'd be much more motivated and actually not stressed or distressed at all by it. They'd be motivated. It would be the you stress, the good stress that was actually motivating them on. So once the thought driving that feeling of stress has been identified, then it's possible to develop a strategy to actually eliminate that stress. So how do we do that? Well, for our ever-readies, if you actually manage an ever-ready by being aware of their behavioural preferences and potential way that they are thinking, you can actually frame the way you present the workload to them. You can make sure that you clearly demonstrate how the work will help them to achieve their targets or their goals. They may be personal, professional, or business goals. It could well be by doing some work that they perceive on the surface not to be worthy of their time. It might be an opportunity for them to actually develop or demonstrate their abilities, their capabilities that would look good when it comes to their next promotion. Again, if you're the manager, you could also perhaps question, why are you giving this work to them in particular? Are they the best person for the work? Why is it important that they actually do it? And let them know why you actually have picked them to do that work. Play to their liking for importance. Now, the other thing just to remember, and this applies across all of the behavioural preferences to anybody in any type of communication, is to be aware of the communication preferences of the person you're speaking to and choose the words which they identify with. So for example, with an ever-ready preference, words such as important, speed, efficiency, achievement, result are all words that will hit home to somebody who has a higher ever-ready preference. If you are ever-ready yourself and the workload has to be completed by you, then you'd need to focus on what is important about this work. Find the reasons why it's worthy of your time. What could you actually gain from doing it? And we might need to go beyond that initial knee-jerk thought and look deeper into it. Can it help you get you've seen and noticed by more senior leaders? Will it give you valuable experience? Will it look good on your CV? So you need to really kind of dig down deeper beyond that kind of surface to find what's in it for me. How can I align this to the things that I value that are worthy of my time?